Luke, it's amazing to have you here with us at Raindance. Congratulations on being an award winner. I guess the first and most obvious question, for people who aren't familiar with the original book and have not yet seen the film, can you tell us just a little bit about what this story is all about and what it was that excited you as a storyteller when you first read that book when you were just 21?
Yeah, so the top line of the book and the film is that a young boy runs away from school where he's being bullied. He hides in an abandoned bathhouse and he falls in love with a water nymph. And so there's aspects of coming of age, there's aspects of fantasy, there's aspects of romance, but there's also some really hard-hitting sort of themes about class and about like financial difficulties and also about just like bullying and alcoholism and things like that.
And obviously at the center you've got a remarkable pairing with James and Rebecca. Can you talk to us about James first and what made him a right fit for our titular hero Arthur Braxton?
So James is, I think, one of the most incredible actors I've ever met, to the point where I never know in real life where when James is actually acting and when he's just being James. He's always in character, and that makes him such a natural actor. And he turned up at these auditions we had, and there was just something about him that just gave him such uniqueness and made you just care about him so much, just automatically, which is so important for a main character.
And obviously, playing someone ethereal who never gets out of the water is a challenging role. What was it about Rebecca that made her the right person to take on that challenge?
Yeah, so we were very lucky with Rebecca because she can swim really well. And I don't think anyone, even like us, the producers, Rebecca, or anybody, really took into account how much time she would be in the water, because she's in the water for the entire film. As for what makes Rebecca so perfect for the role, she gives such passion, and she's able to be simultaneously the kind of like naivety that we have from Delfina, because Delfina has never met anybody. Her character has lived in this pool, has only ever seen two people in her entire life, but then is able to give such passion and ferocity when it's needed around sort of two-thirds of the way through the film. Spoilers.
Obviously, alongside those young talents, you have the very familiar face of Mr. Johnny Vegas. Can you talk a little bit about what he brings to the production and whether or not it's maybe the kind of comedic persona that people, I guess, always associate him with?
So, Johnny, we were so lucky to have Johnny come in. We had him, we actually already started production when we found out Johnny was actually coming in. So we were really cutting it fine because we hadn't cast it. We were holding out for Johnny, and actually I wrote the character with Johnny in mind. What makes Johnny so unique is that, I mean, he himself has dealt with some of the problems that his character has dealt with, and he's overcome them. But in terms of him being a comedian, one of the things I've heard a lot in the industry is you can get actors, you can't get actors who are not funny to be funny, but you can get funny people to act really well. And Johnny, I mean, I really hope he goes on to just act and act and act and act and act. There's this adorable scene in one of his TV shows about glamping, where his mum says, "Oh, I don't like all this acting, all this comedy stuff you do. I want you to be a real actor." And I really hope that, you know, in Arthur Braxton and in other acting roles he's done, he's found another love, right?
Talking about finding another love, obviously, many fans will be very familiar with you from your years and amazing amount of work on YouTube. I'm curious about the move to being a feature director and if that was something that was always a goal for you or something you've just naturally gravitated to over time.
Yeah, so I started YouTube when I was 15 years old, and I got so into it that basically I kind of didn't really try very hard at school because I was so distracted making YouTube videos. And my excuse to my parents was always, at the age of 15, 16, I'm going to do YouTube, I'm going to get an audience, and I'm one day going to be able to make a film. And I have no idea if I actually fully believed that, but that is what happened. And so film was my original love. YouTube came along in 2009, and I had already been making films at home with my friends for years and years.
I mean, obviously, over the last couple of years, we've all been asking ourselves those big soul-searching questions, and I think a very common one has been why storytelling matters so much in our lives. I'm curious if you have an answer to that big question and what it means for you to be this kind of a storyteller.
Yeah, so I think we as humans, we try to make sense of the world through stories. The world is made up of so much information, our minds can't possibly actually process it, and so our brains sort of turn that into a story that isn't necessarily true, but it is helpful to make sense of the world. And so we're naturally storytellers. And then with storytelling, my goal is always to create something that just, you can't put your finger on it, but it feels true. And so finding that is the most satisfying thing you can do in filmmaking, and it's why I think films work so well, and books, and all the other types of stories. The most important thing to take away from this film, I think, is that people are not all one thing. I think a lot of the time we try and sort of typecast people as in certain ways and say people are just bad, are just good, are just hardworking, are just lazy, all that kind of thing. And in Other Braxton, we really try and inject a bit of like gray area into those things. The other thing, this is a bit of I don't want to spoil the end actually, because there is a real takeaway at the end, and I can sum it up in about 5 words, but I will ruin the end of the film, and I cannot do that.
You're here at Raindance. What does it mean for you not only to be part of the festival, but to have the film already have been successful in this year's awards ceremony, honored in the way it has been?
I mean, to be at Raindance at all already meant so much, but to have won UK Best Feature at Raindance for this film that we have poured our heart and soul into for 4 or 5 years, 6 years in the case of me and my producer, it just means so much. And especially to have my first feature. I've come from a different world. I'm not originally a filmmaker, I'm a YouTuber, and that comes with it a lot of baggage. And so to have an award for the film we have made to validate the fact that we're actually all right at what we do is not only really like an honor, it's also really valuable and really important to us, because, and important to me, because it means I can believe in myself, right? Not that external validation is all that matters, but it means so much. I honestly haven't come up against really any resistance to the fact that I'm a YouTuber trying to make it in other worlds. Especially, I did when I started. When I started, the idea that I was even going to be a YouTuber was a ridiculous suggestion, because being a YouTuber wasn't a thing yet. But in terms of like trying to make it in other worlds, I think being a YouTuber and sort of social media world in general has sort of reached a point where it's entered into the mainstream. And I've only ever heard people say, ooh, being a YouTuber might be a problem for you. I've never actually found it to be a problem. I don't know where I'll be with YouTube, to be honest. I never want to give it up. I don't want to do like a hard cut, that's it, I'm done, because I value having an outlet that is mine that I completely control. Ultimately, when you're making a film, there's so many layers of people in between what I want to make. There's money problems, there are producers, there's distributors, there's all these other interests, and all valid interests. But I value having a direct outlet that I can have with an audience, whether that's YouTube, whether it's Instagram, whether it's TikTok, whether it's whatever. I really value that, and I'm not going to throw it away.